For years we walked, at times hand in hand. At others, him in front, me behind, never the reverse. Seldom speaking, words he said, stains on silence, unwanted, unneeded, unanswered. All, always unanswered. Yet I bled inside. When we did speak, a question or a statement, there was never a reply. The act itself, a slow stream of air, shaped by lips and tongue, forming sounds, ones which, by local convention, carried meaning, though they meant nothing to him. In time, nothing to me, which was not quite enough. Early on, I would pause, thinking no more to follow. Still a child, though not in years. But I would again go on, one foot in front of the other. At times, I thought to ask why, but no point. Words, mere stains. So I sought some diversion, an entertainment. At times I played with gait, a game. But soon, all too soon, I again placed one foot in front of the other. There is beauty in all things, even in silence, especially in silence, in darkness. In the deafening stillness of a moonless night, a child knows. Children know the truth of what I speak, though it may only show in their eyes. Yet even in a child's dreams, this is not quite enough. We are not solitary creatures built to course life's road alone. Forever alone. Yet this was all that was left to me. One foot, then another, until the day we parted. I cried the day he went on, beyond the horizon, out of sight. He said, or motioned, told me in some way, he needed me no more. That I, or he, must go. With that, I stopped, in shock or dread, stood, then fell, frozen, fighting back a feeling I could neither name nor explain. Finally, I offered him my hand. This, the threat of solitude, my attempt to erase. All for naught. Without a glance, he walked on, over the horizon, into a neither here nor there, and was gone. Me, still so young, this, my first time, alone. I stood, motionless. It felt so wrong. Waiting, without movement. How could he? Had I done something wrong? Had I offended him so much as to make him move on? In time, I began to play again. Movement, gait. I fancied myself a dancer. Now posed, poised. A plié, then another, a tendu, rond de jambe. I know not whence this came. My body, my hips, my legs, these awkward appendages on an eerily frozen frame, seemingly moving on their own. Then, words, not mere sounds. A war raging within me to move or stay, to stand, or I could be still no more. Long years of walking, one foot in front of the other, always ahead, never side to side, days passing into nights. Yet, suddenly, now, me, alive. That night, he touched me as we lay together, not as one, as we, as always, alone. Then his hand, no longer in mine, his arms, his breath, the unthinkable, silence, shrouded in sadness, smothered with shame.
Thank you.
Our daughter, are we one? Fullness of life. Is that why he went on? Ahead? Faded from sight? No more a part of our days, our nights. Emma and me, we, now alone. We were enough, yes, together. Emma and me, enough. At least enough for me. I prayed it to be the same for her. Yet doubt. Unsure, though certain that going on was our only cure. I once dreamed, when Emma's age, of a different life, of snowy nights, scented blossoms, a father's touch, my own long gone, unknown to me, of a normal life, or so it seemed. To play, made up games, made up names of imaginary creatures, Norwin, Sigrid, Aniki. I knew their stories, following reindeer, surviving, thriving amidst the tracks of their own lives. These who went before. Among these misty images, within the echoes of their names, one vague notion occurred again and again. An inexplicable sense. I had once danced, yet I knew not how. Everything I knew was of him, from him. As we walked, he and I, only ever walked, hand in hand, one foot in front of the other, seldom, never looking up. Silence, our only solace. Our souls not save the need to go on. How was I to teach her what I myself did not know? It seemed simple enough, raising a child, though barely more than one myself. Yet years of walking, head bowed, eyes down, counting each step. Thousands upon thousands of steps, seldom speaking. Me wanting more, yet not even knowing if there was a more, or if so, what it might be. Every desire I ever knew was first his own, or so he said. Yet now, a feeling I didn't fully comprehend held me firmly in her hand. Emma. Emma, this beautiful child. Could I be content to have her step, hand in hand, counting, head down? I knew in my heart. No, I knew here. I could not. It was not the way I would want her to be. Yet I knew no more than that. I could only stop. Raise a leg as though to dance. Then, one day, she did the same, as though a mere image of me. Only better, more free. Soon, in arabesque, I felt tied by invisible cords, a marionette compelled to do the same. Awkward, unsteady. Yet I tried to move the same as she. But I could not. I fell out. She continued on, but did not move away. She stayed, danced on. Soon a desire, my very own, came to me. For the first time ever, I, me, wanted to be free. The choking hand of my past life opened, and I, in release, in relief, sank to my knees, gave thanks. She came to me, offered her hand as I had once done myself, and I saw, in that gesture, in the offer of her hand, a universe unfolding, a bewildering unknown, but one so warm. And though I knew not what lay ahead, I rose, took her hand, and we walked on. Emma and me, into a destiny, now all quite enough.
Thank you.